to be the most effective appetite suppressant ever. Not just any diet toothpaste, the ultimate diet toothpaste. Yes, but don't kill the mother if it's avoidable. We've need of her to replenish our stocks. I think there's gas in the lab somewhere that can be used to put them out. The research is in the safe in my office. You'll have need of my code and keycard. The lab's entrance is in the side of a hill. You can't miss it if you just follow the road. You'll pass by the town's original... by the grand architect. Jameson. He's in the old lab. That would surely lighten the weight on my conscience, as I am held to account for the well-being of every scientist here. Too many have been lost. Too many black marks against my name, as it were. And far too much paperwork.
I don't know about Dr. Crane's research, but we ought to find Mr. Jameson. He's gotta be all alone and scared. Isn't this pretty, Captain? I love all the trees. We ought to go places like this more. Mysterious doors are the funnest sorts of doors. Looks like they gotta back up somewheres. Maybe even a Fatberg.
Let's go!
Be right over.
You! Over here! Oh, good. You're not shooting at me. That's a start. It's been a bit of a day, so I'll get to the point. Yes, I have Crane's research. No, I'm not giving it back. Sorry to disappoint you. Yes, I imagine he does. But we all have problems. It is the human condition. You want to kill me. I don't want to die. Therefore, it is in my best interest to negotiate with you. Help me get out of here, and I will pay you for my life. The first thing I need is a key card to unlock my door. Then I'd need you to clear me a path out of here. There are two ways out. The quickest is through the front door, but Cleo security's bottled up in there. If you don't want to shoot them, I suppose you could talk to them. The other way out is through the loading bay, but you'd have to clear out the wraps for me. Then I could just slip out the back, sight unseen. You might be the first stroke of luck I've had all day. Thank you. I'm in your debt. Take your time. I am, to my chagrin, not going anywhere.
Searching for an
armor.
I think you could jimmy that one proper, Captain. Doesn't look too tough. All right. Wait, I'm on the move.
I've never been so pleased at the sight of it. Please tell me you've cleared a way out of here. So you have. I am much obliged. And now, if you do not mind, I have had quite enough of this wretched place. Oh, really? And why, pray tell, would I do a thing like that? I should ask you the same thing. Make me an offer.
something you need?
Who the... You. Yeah, you. Get over here. You done a job of work. After you cacked their employer, the gun hand started surrendering. Or trying to slip out. We heard it all from up here. Hell of a thing. Get down to Roseway and talk to Doc Crane. He'll make sure you get what's yours.
My way.
You've returned. Please tell me you've recovered my research. Without my work to focus on, I find myself tending towards darker paths of inquiry. An experiment? What experiment? Do you see what I have to contend with here? There seems no end to my associates' capacity for doing everything but their jobs. I will need to look into this further. You've returned. Please tell me. My research? Please tell me you've recovered it. That's... You can't possibly understand the enormity of what you've done for me. Did you find my colleague, Jameson? Well, please keep me apprised of your progress as to that matter. I suppose you've earned it. It's highly illegal to have brought the Raptodons to Terra 2. The research done on them before Monarch was left to the dregs was too promising to just abandon, so here we are. You've not much idea how these things work, do you? If Auntie Cleo could be connected to what we're doing here, they'd be ruined. Everyone skirts the law looking for an edge, but the ultimate sin is to be exposed. Plausible deniability is everything.
Other 16 were closed?
I don't think you're supposed to be wandering around. Want to treat yourself before you go? Sure. Not like I get many customers. Sure. You need something to clean Raptodon blood out your clothes? Did security talk to you yet?
Underestimating the importance of the eighth back.
Language.
I got 500 bits on the Darlings taking the finals this year.
If those yellow walls all day, I'd make a point to sleep on the roof. Gotta be where Mr. Jameson is. I hope he's okay.
Okay, here we go!
That wasn't a load-bearing mole.
Unexpected. Performing.
Here we go!
Processing.
Thank you.
Yes? Did... That is tragic news. I never did right by him. Only cared about how he helped or how... Yes? I suppose...
Did you bring me anything? New parts? Last week? Destination reached. The Groundbreaker.
Family life, Felix? Did you ever know him?
I never knew him. I was a stowaway. That's what they call orphans who grow up in the back bays.
Oh, gosh. I'm sorry. I must have been lonesome.
Come on, Parvati. Who are you talking to? Imagine me pining after my family. Yeah, I suppose I was a touch lonesome. But hey, look at me now. I made it. I got a ship and everything. The old rest and go. All the luxury and comfort of a...
Have you had a moment to look into that little opportunity I told you about on Roseway? You don't hurry up. Someone will get to snooping around there before you do. What's that? Speak up now. What'd you turn up? Well, that's just swell, sweetheart. Good for you. A shame you didn't visit old Gladys first. That would have fetched a good price. I may have thrown in a batch of my famous sugar cookies just to sweeten the deal. If Auntie Cleo's exporting rats from Monarch, golly me, someone's going to be in the soup when they get caught. Are you positive? Honest to goodness? I suppose it can't be helped. Law bless you for doing the legwork, sweetie. Don't forget your pal Gladys now. You can come visit anytime. Straight to the point, eh? All right then, on you go. Anytime, sweetheart. You know where to find me. Great law, is it hot in here? I've got a lovely little throw pillow. Just something I tossed together. Like...
So, how's this work? Do we get a table? Stand in a corner?
Okay, so... what are we drinking? Oh, and don't worry on the... Oh! Bottoms up!
Beer, huh? Good choice, if you want to get unsober in a hurry.
Ah, this tastes like the underside of a boot. People drink that for fun? Oh, Captain, I'm pining for June like something fierce. What am I doing? Huh. Yeah. I guess we are that, huh? Friends. Friends give each other counsel, right? What do you think I should do about June Lei? Because I feel about as aimless as an automech with a busted nav chip.
You want to know what I think? I think you should write what you want to say down on your hand. Always worked for me.
You and me both, Captain. I'm just... she brought up another lady, you know? Isabel. Why would she do that? Maybe I've been making a right fool of myself this whole time. Maybe she's not... you know, that's a given, Captain. I can't not worry myself to bits about the things that matter to me. It was real long and rambly. She was telling me a story about her dad. How a lady named Isabel did all sorts of things to try to win his favor. This Isabel lady never quite managed to get her dad's approval, but they carried on anyways. Made something good out of a bad situation. Then it all went down the tubes. Do you think June Lei still has feelings for her? I just got a lot of feelings, Captain, and they're all climbing up my throat. I need another drink. Right now. Before I lose my nerve.
Come on, Captain. I'm here to drink.
Okay, maybe you're right. I am a little woozy.
Hydration, here I come.
Good thinking, boss. You just saved Parvati a whole lot of trouble.
Shush you.
Oh, Captain, I want to talk to Junlei all the time. Even about silly things, but I'm so scared.
Figuring feelings ain't so easy as saying words, Captain. Someone so brave as you, well, you can't understand.
Does she think I'm as pretty as I think she's handsome? What if she doesn't like me? What if she does? What if she's still got feelings for that lady, Isabel? What if we get together and she gets bored of me?
Don't you tease me in my moment of weakness. You know I'm not interested in physical affection.
That's... Well, it's tripped folks up in the past. Folks I thought cared about me for me. What if she's not okay with that? What if she is, but then later, she's not? Just move on? Like, snapping your fingers? I don't know. Maybe I got a weak heart. It all just seems... impossible. Yeah. Yeah, I know you're right. Just wish it were that easy, is all. I'm not used to speaking free with folks. Back in Edgewater, there wasn't no one who wanted to know my mind. Excepting my dad. Gosh, I don't know that I got that in me. Sometimes I feel real mean inside, Captain. I think... ungenerous thoughts. Yeah. I like the way you put that, like... it's okay to want to be better for her, and not impossible to try. Well, Captain, this has been... this has been a whole lot. I got just... wow. So much to think about. Oh gosh, I don't know, Captain. Do you think I should?
All right. There's no need to strip your screws over it.
Okay. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna ask June out. Just as soon as we get back to the ship. I mean, probably. Eventually. Thanks for hearing me out and giving me counsel. And, well, for being a friend. It means a whole lot. You're good people, Captain.
You know something, Parvati? You ought to come drinking with the crew more often.
Oh, all right. Thank you, guys. You're real good friends, you know that? I wish there was a place we could all live quiet together. Come on, let's go.
Had a conveyor pull in?
Huh? Oh.
Hey, Captain. I hope I wasn't too much bother at the bar. I did have fun, and I tried some things I never would have otherwise. And I don't feel it today. I guess that water must have worked. I'm glad I had you looking out for me. I wouldn't mind having a drink again. Someday. In the distant future. Anyway. I messaged Junlei when we got back and she replied super quick. Okay. I was awake half the night, thinking about what I sent, anxious to see what you said. I reread my message in the morning, and it was unclear. I was drinking when I sent it, otherwise I wouldn't have had the courage. Also, sorry for the typos. I've ruined things in the past because I didn't say things I should have, like, I've met someone who's become special to me. I want to be honest with her, so if she feels the same about me, there won't be any surprises. Oh, isn't she sweet? Like one of those two-bit romances where one soul's all stiff and formal and... I should be glad to perhaps take hold of your hand, miss. I ought to go write her back. I mean, I already did. Twice. But anyhow, thanks for taking me out, Captain.